In this video, we're going to be taking a look at the new iteration of the GoPro tripod mounts. So the new kit includes two different tripod mounts. The traditional tripod mount, that's this one here, which is the same tripod mount we've seen before, and the buckle mount base plate tripod mount. This is the new one. This is really cool because it has 2 1/4 by 20 inch threaded bolts on the bottom of it and a buckle mount on the top. To mount your GoPro onto this, you first need to mount your GoPro onto a buckle mount and then you can slide it onto the tripod mount. With the traditional GoPro mount or traditional tripod mount, we would just slide our camera into the base and then mount. With this new one, we need our buckle mount first and then we can mount onto the tripod mount. So what's the value of two different tripod screws on the bottom? Well, first off, I think they just had space and it was something to add, but I do see the value. Depending on the layout of your base plate, of your tripod, you can take advantage of either one of these. And then also some base plates have a second pin that would fit into one of these two holes to keep the camera from spinning. So you can actually lock out what direction it goes and stop any movement of the camera unspinning off of the tripod. I think the addition of the buckle mount, tripod mount to the tripod mount kit is really cool and it follows suit of the direction that GoPro has been moving lately. We've seen the addition of buckle mount plates on almost all of their accessories. The suction cup mount has it, the Jaws flex clamp has it, and those are the two big ones that are coming to mind right now that didn't used to. So the suction cup mount really didn't used to have a buckle mount base plate, and quite honestly, the Jaws, especially the gooseneck, probably shouldn't have had a base plate, but it does. And that's quite interesting. And I think it's going in this direction that GoPro wants all of their mounts to be mountable using this base plate. So if you were to say have a mount set up, you had one mount on your tripod, you had your Jaws set up, and then a suction cup mount, you could very easily switch between them by just taking the camera off of the base plate, and then just moving it onto the next buckle mount you had set up. As you guys know, I am a huge fan of the GoPro tripod mounts, and I think that they are one of the most essential pieces of gear you can have in your kit. They're super cheap, but they add a lot of flexibility. Now, I actually rarely mount my GoPro onto a tripod using the tripod mounts, but my use for them is in DIY mounts. I use the tripod mount in almost all of my DIY mounts because it's super easy to mount onto things. I use it in my DIY clamp mounts, my DIY rigs, my backpack mounts, the pole mount. All of those things use the GoPro tripod mount. Now, the reason for that is these are a 1/4 by 20 inch screw and those are really easy to pick up at the hardware store. You can pick up 1/4 by 20 inch bolts for pennies. I did a DIY handlebar mount. You can get U-bolts that are threaded 1/4 by 20 and you can just throw the U-bolts onto roll bars and then mount your tripod mount right onto that. So they're super versatile and easy to use, and they're really hugely important, especially if you want to make any DIY mounts. Thank you guys for watching. This was another GoPro tips and tricks video. If you've enjoyed it, please make sure you subscribe, check out my channel for lots more videos, and like the video. Until next time, guys, thank you very much for watching.